Hello, I'm Hayley Leggs with TotalRock, and I'm here at Bloodstock 2012 with Kirk from Crowbar.
How are you, Hayley?
I'm fucking fantastic, thank you. Kirk, how are you?
I'm good, thanks. We had a great show. Really good vibe, good crowd. It was cool.
Yeah, I was watching it. It was excellent. It was a really excellent show. How did you feel about it? Was it good in comparison to the other shows you've been doing lately?
Yeah, we've been lucky. We've only had one kind of semi-lame show in the last week and a half. Everything else has been...
Why was it lame?
It was an add-on show in a small little, in the middle of nowhere, Germany kind of thing.
Yeah.
Everything else has been really good, and today was great. You know, I thought the crowd was great. We did a signing a couple of minutes ago, and I was really pleased with the turnout.
Yeah, I saw the line for that. It was crazy.
Good. So we're, you know, just happy to be out promoting Crowbar.
Have you been out on tour for long?
Only about a week, basically, 8 days, whatever. But we had done like, 12, 14 days in July, and we flew home for like 2.5 weeks and came back for 16 shows. Then I go back, and then down starts in America in September, then down comes over here in October, so I'm busy every month.
Yeah, and we'll keep him busy with the good
stuff. 2.5 weeks of each month is touring, so.
So you've been, I know, down have released, like, you're releasing 4 EPs in a row, right? What was
right.
the idea behind that?
Number one, I don't think anybody's done it, and with the state of the music industry as far as record sales and or lack thereof, you know, and with people with that, you know, online stuff like iTunes and stuff like that, we figured it'd be a cheaper product for them to buy. We can get it out quicker because we're all involved with so many other things. It's where we can put out down music, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, instead of taking 5, 6, and 7 years between each record, maybe, you know, we can get it out a little quicker. And I just think at this, you know, the state of the music industry right now, it's a good idea and a good approach to kind of combat the negative side of what's going on in the industry and just do something fresh and different. And there's so many elements to the sound of down that this first one's our heavy one. This is heavy. And we don't know what the next one's going to be. It could be bluesy, it could be doom, it could be... You know, we don't know.
So you don't have the songs planned out all yet. You're just going to do it as they come to you.
Yeah, it's the way we work. It's all spontaneous. We have leftover songs, of course, but doesn't mean we're going to use them. When we get together, you know, first and foremost, we need to get this one out, tour on this, and hope that, you know, everyone loves it as much as we love it. And then we'll take it from there.
Oh, fantastic. Yeah, I've heard a couple of songs from the first one, and it was... Absolutely, exactly what I would hope for. Really, really good songs, yeah.
Awesome, thank you. That's what, we wanted to sound like you're in the jam room with Down. We wanted to sound like a good demo, you know. We captured the feel we were looking for, which is the real vibe of what we do. It's not perfect, and that's the thing. I mean, so many bands today do everything on Pro Tools, everything on the grid, every kick drum's locked in perfect, every note is hit perfect. We just go old school like Sabbath and, you know, all Thin Lizzy and whatever. We just jam. If it's a good take, we like it. We're going a lot more for the feel than we are for, musical precisionship, for lack of a better term. But we're real happy with the way it turned out. We think it's great.
Yeah, I don't think there's a band quite like Down, absolutely.
I agree, and thank you.
So you've got Down, who I'm a huge fan of, Kingdom of Sorrow, also love, and Crowbar. Is there one particular band that takes priority, or does it, like, take turns?
Yeah, it depends. I mean, it's either Down or Crowbar flip-flopping, depending on our scheduling. When Down wants to do something, Down pretty much takes priority, but that gives me plenty of time with Crowbar, plenty of time for Jimmy Bauer with I Hate God, you know. It's usually Down as priority, but if Down takes a break for a while, boom, I book a bunch of Crowbar stuff, do some Kingdom stuff in between, and it's all good, you know.
Are you planning to ever tour anything with Kingdom of Sorrow in the UK?
We've talked about it, and I'm sure we will at some point.
So Jamie's here this weekend. Have you been hanging out?
I went to his bus. He's sleeping, lazy bastard.
Lazy
but
bastard.
He's going to be hanging with Crowbar the next few days, and then his Jasta solo project's playing a few shows with Crowbar. And then
No way. That's awesome. I love that stuff.
A special thing at Summer Breeze Festival next weekend. It's Jasta and Windstein. Jasta versus Windstein, something they're calling it. And we're going to actually... He's going to do a few solo songs. I'm going to come out. We're going to do some Kingdom of Sorrow material. And he'll come back and finish up the rest of the show with his solo stuff. So that'll be fun, too. So, you know.
So how does it differ? Crowbar's like your baby. You're the front man.
Sure.
How is that in comparison to playing with Down, which is like, you know, it's, you know, Phil's fronting it. Do you, is it the same amount of power between both? Do you feel the same kind of affection for both projects?
No, I mean, I feel the same affection for both projects, sure. It's different. I mean, you know, like you say, I mean, I'm the only original member. I'm the chief songwriter. I'm the singer. I'm the lyricist. I'm the whatever. So, of course, I have more control and what direction I want to take Crowbar and what we do. And the other guys are cool with that, but I try to get them as involved as possible. With Down, it's a lot more of a, you know, democracy thing, and everyone's got their own input, and we try to listen and feed off each other's ideas, and we clash heads at times, but, you know, I think the end product speaks for itself.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. It was an excellent show there today.
Oh, thank you.
And so you brought out an album for Crowbar last year, is that right? Have you got any more plans to do anything coming up anytime soon?
Yeah, I mean, we're writing already, so... trying to do, we had recorded the live record a few years ago in South Louisiana, 10 live tracks for Crowbar that we're hoping to do on Phillips Housecore Records. Try to do maybe a couple of studio tracks as well, brand new unreleased stuff, and then write the new Crowbar following that. But we're writing as we speak, you know, so.
I can't wait.
It never stops. You know.
So you're the lyricist for Crowbar. Where does the inspiration come from?
Honestly, I just write down my thoughts. I mean, I don't write fictitious, you know, stories or anything. Whatever I feel that day when I write it, it's what it is. It's life, you know, it's ups and downs, and just finding the good through the hard times, basically.
Great.
It's a positive, you know, it may sound heavy and dark, and subject matter's dark, of course, but the bottom line is, what I want to accomplish with my lyrics is to help people realize they're not alone when they're really down in the dumps or having problems, you know, whatever those problems may be. And, you know, there's always a light at the end of the tunnel, and just hang in there and be strong, you know.
Yeah. Oh, fantastic. Well, it was lovely speaking to you. Kirk from Crowbar, ladies and gentlemen.